origin through history to show you how the Christmas we know and love came to be.
And you guess how it all started? It has a calling, we must and God is there. So we are going to show the history of how we make our way to the kind of Christmas we enjoy today. It's a time to celebrate, a time for family, a time for presents and for hanging baubles on the tree, a time for caring and for sharing, a time for lots of bo. That's the Christmas we have come to know.
Let's talk back to ancient Rome during the week before the winter solstice, December the 25th. People celebrated the ancient festival of Saturnalia. December the 25th, sound familiar?
Saturnalia was a week of feasting and drinking in honour of Saturn, the god of agriculture. Saturnalia was also a time for social role rehearsal. Slaves would become masters for a household and masters would become slaves for a whole week.
Women would take part in gladiator fights, and wealthy citizens would dress in rags and give their money to the poor. Everything went kind of topsy-turvy during Saturnalia.
Oh, Saturnalia, Saturnalia, when people feast and act the clown, and everything is always topsy-turvy, back to front and upside down. This celebrated ancient festival in December's darkest days. Let the citizens of Rome make merry in the strangest ways. Masters became the slaves, and slaves the masters. A twist of social role, and to eat and to drink till they all could eat and drink no more was the goal. Oh, Saturnalia, Saturnalia, when people feast and act the clown, and everything is always topsy-turvy, back to front and upside down. And if you'd been around, you would have witnessed some quite confusing sights. Women wearing armour, facing off in gladiator fights, and wealthy people dressed in rags and giving their money to the poor. Such a pity it lasted for one short week. We could always do with some more.
Well, in the early centuries AD, pagans from Northern Europe would also feast and drink a lot more the solstice. They called the celebration more.
In Scandinavia, they would burn a huge oil throughout the celebration. It lasted for 12 days.
12 days of Yule and a lot more things you might recognise.
The cattle were slaughtered and the meat provided, lots to feast upon Yule and for the rest of the winter.
Barrels of ale were opened and toast scale was shouted at every opportunity.
Mistletoes were hung up in dedication to Frigga, their goddess of love. We all know what goes under a mistletoe these days, and it was the same back then.
I'm
ones on modern celebrations with lots of features we still see today.
But things really took a turn in the 4th century AD and the Constantine Christ side became the religion of the Roman Empire.
The Bible never mentioned a date of the birth of Jesus, so no holidays or festivals can be organised to celebrate it.
Pope Julius I declared that it should be celebrated on December 25th to tie up with Saturnalia. The Romans could still have a merry time during the solstice, but the reason for the celebration had changed.
So the festival of the Nativity was introduced. The story of the birth of God's Son in a stable in Bethlehem would now forever be at the heart of winter festivities.
Under Cromwell and the Puritans, who had very strict religious rules, Christmas would no longer be a holiday or time for fun.
Soldiers would confiscate food they expect was being prepared. In celebration, alcohol was banned.
As was the decorating of homes, and unless it fell on Sunday the 25th of December was a day for working and business as usual.
Puritans believed that avoiding pleasurable pastimes could gain them a place in heaven. At least for a while, it was curtains for Christmas.
Thank you.
Roman king, Christmas again became a public holiday and a time to celebrate.
But it was during the Victorian age that it started to look more like the Christmas we recognise today.
At the image of a family together, with the children at the centre of things, really captured the nation's imaginations during Victorian times.
Cracker, Christmas cards, carol singers, fruit-filled mince pie and the all-important turkey dinner.
But only for the wealthier, families become popular and are still a feature of Christmas today.
When Victoria married Albert, he brought her something from Germany that has stayed with us ever since. The Christmas tree!
Prince Albert married Victoria and came to join us here. He introduced to Christmas us with such a bright idea. A favourite feature he passed on from life in Germany. Would add some glamour to your house and a good old Christmas tree. The Victorians loved their Christmas.
Thank you. about how Christmas came to be.